We are here at the second lecture on conductive molecules. Now we learned which are the molecules and which are the wires that we can build. And let's pass in this lecture to analyze these structures, these molecules, doing some simulation. We know that for having current, we must put them out of the equilibrium. And then we will analyze the most important factors that influence the current, which type of molecules we have, the length of the wire, the planarity of the wire, of the molecule structure, and the bonds. And then I will finish this lecture showing you some experimental results. For studying the molecules of our interest, we must use this chemistry that is named computational chemistry, and it is useful for simulating the chemical and electronic characteristics. For in computational chemistry, we have two main approaches. One, it is what is named ab initio. Ab initio from Latin is from start. And so you study your molecule and its characteristics directly solving the Schrödinger equation from scratch, from start. There are two different techniques. The most diffused different techniques are the DFT, the density functional theory, and the HF, the R3-Fock theory. The other approach, it is was named the half-empirical. Half-empirical because, again, you have to solve the Schrödinger equation, but you do not start from start, but from scratch, but you start from already some solved problems based on empirical parameters. And, for example, one of the most famous methods is the Ackel method. For having a current, we must put the molecule out of the equilibrium, and so we must study and simulate our molecules out of equilibrium. And in this case, the Schrödinger equation is not enough, and so we must apply, taking it from the quantum conductance theory and the non-equilibrium of these molecules, what is named the NEGF, the non-equilibrium Green's function. The first thing that we must do for studying a molecule is to optimize its structure. So we must study the molecule, put down the atoms, how is built the structure, and then to give to our simulator the characteristics, the information needed to work on it, and to have information about mainly the two important information that are the length and the angles of the bonds between the atoms that constitute the molecule. This process is iterative, and it is based on the fact that we want to find the best energy state to reach the equilibrium. So the first point is to study the molecule, optimize it to reach and to have it in an equilibrium state. For example, studying thiophene molecules, that, as I told you, they are the ones that we will use experimentally, so let's have a look of them. Here you have an example of a molecule that we studied using the software named Gaussian. And in A here, you have a not optimized structure. When you apply Gaussian and the software, you can have the final result B, where you have the optimized structure. So it means that this state of the molecule is the best in terms of energy, and it is the most stable. And so this is the result from which you start your study and analysis. Another interesting information that we must have from our simulators is the Homo-Lumo gap, because it's strictly related to conductance and current. And, for example, using these softwares, you can study how the Homo-Lumo gap changes depending, in this case, on the number of thiophene rings that you have. The interesting information, and this is why we will do some more precise analysis about it, is that as much as the wire becomes longer, the two Homo, Lumo and Homo level will become with a lower distance between them. And so the molecule becomes longer and you have a decrease in Homo-Lumo gap. So we will see that we have two opposite effects. The distance, the length of a molecule becomes longer, and so it means that the current, the conductance, in this case, decreases. But from the other side, the Homo-Lumo gap decreases, but it is a point in which you have, as a consequence, an increase in conductance and current. So this will be an interesting point to study later, and we will do it. So after it, I want also to show you how to study the molecule out of equilibrium, and in this case, a good tool that we chose is Atomistic's Virtual Nanolab. With VNL, Virtual Nanolab, it's possible to have DFT and also the NEGF method to apply. And what you do, in this case, you define a central region, a left electrode and the right electrode, and you apply your voltage to this structure. So we will have here, from all the regions, the Hamiltonian matrices useful for obtaining and doing the calculation of the current inside the structure. And in the central region, you have your molecule with the Hamiltonian. On the left and on the right, you have the electrodes with their related Hamiltonians. And with this structure, we can extract the IV characteristics, the transmission spectrum, we will see that it is an interesting information, and other molecular parameters. We will study thiolated thiophenes that we will call them TT for simplifying the name, and we will change the number of rings and we will study them. And these molecules, we will bond them to two gold electrodes. Let's spend a few words about the transmission spectrum. The analysis of the transmission spectrum gives us important information about the energy structure of our molecule and our molecule inside the two electrodes. Here is an example of a third thiophene molecule, where you see this is the resulting transmission spectrum, where you have a direct relation between the energy level of a molecule inside the electrodes and the transmission spectrum itself. If you remember, the transmission spectrum is related to the density of states and the quality of the contact, the famous gamma. And here is the point, the current of the molecule is proportional to the integral of the transmission spectrum, so we can say to an area. And we will see soon where and which is this area. Talking about the quality of contacts, let's start to use this transmission spectrum to understand things. In this case, here we have two different contacts, one good and one bad. We can immediately see that, you see, here the A, the first on your, this transmission spectrum on your left, is a transmission spectrum related to a good contact, because you have a very good probability related to the transmission spectrum to have an electron moving inside your structure. On the right, you see, there is a situation where the contacts are bad. In fact, the transmission spectrum, you have some possibilities, some probabilities, but you can see a big difference, so very, very, very lower. And one interesting point is also that if you have good level of transmission spectrum around the Fermi level, that is the point where you can have a good performance in terms of conductance and current. So, let's see how to have, in this case, you cannot do the direct calculation of the current starting from these plots, but you can have a direct feeling of how much is the current, where are the differences in currents in your device. In fact, here there is an example where on the same structure we apply zero, a voltage for giving an energy of 0 electron volt, 1 and 2 electron volts. First point to mention, you see that from theory of this structure, MMM structure, the application of the voltage, it changes the transmission spectrum. So the positions and the situation of the energy levels inside your molecules are not fixed, but depends also on what you are applying, on the voltage that you are applying. And so this is the first important point. The second important point is that, you see, applying this, we at the end go to, let's say, give an energy that covers different regions of our transmission spectrum. And in this case, doing the correct calculation, we can see that here, this area compared to this one is less large, is an area that doing the calculation we can obtain about 8.7 microamperes. In this case, applying 2 electron volts, this gives us a current of 18.95 microamperes. So, analyzing the transmission spectrum, it is a very interesting approach for having a good idea, an immediate idea of the current that you can have in your device. And here I show you a plot where, applying the different voltages, at the end we obtain different currents inside this example that I did. Okay? Now, let's pass with these tools for studying conductance and current, which are the factors that influence our current. The first one is the type of the molecules. Then we can also analyze differences, talking about the length of our chain, the rotation of the rings, because it is not mandatory and it is not sure that your rings are on the same plane. They can rotate for external conditioning. And then also, we already did it, the influence of giving a polarization to the electrode, and in this case, it changes the energy level of our structure. And also, how is bonded our molecule to the external electrodes. Well, about the types of molecules, we already spent a few words in the previous lecture, and here I took these results from a paper mentioned here, where they did a comparison between five different molecules. Here in the plot, we have three of them. The number one, that is an alkane. The number three, that is an OPE. And the number five, that is an OPV. You see, in a real experiment, what we said last time. Last time I told you that OPV are more conductive than OPE and more conductive of the alkane. I told you are isolating. Of course, they can have a current, but a lower current in comparison with the other structures. In another paper, I want to show you, in this case, the four molecules that they analyzed using, in this case, a mechanically controllable break junction. So what I show you before, where you break mechanically the wire, and so you create the junction in this way. I mentioned you this, and I forgot also to point you out that in this case, the technique to create the contact with the molecules is a cross wire. So in this previous paper that I mentioned, you have a cross wire and you put the molecule in the middle. Here you have a controllable break junction, so a planar electrode. I mention you this because it's strictly related, the result of the quantity of current you have, to the contacts, to the way of how you do the contact. So here in this paper, they study these three different molecules, and we can obtain from these four different molecules I go back because I want to show you. This is the behavior of one of the molecules, and so in this case we are talking of this of three TT, so studying the three thiophene thiolated molecule, you obtain this current, and here we are talking of about 500, 1,000, so microamps, so 500 nanoamps. The maximum here is 1 microampere. And here you see from the transmission spectrum of the four molecules the differences that will give you differences in conduction and in current. And from those transition spectrum, they also did some comparisons in, you see here, you have the differences in, this is the lower line corresponds to the C12, so to the alkane, and the others are the OPE, OPV, and the thiophenes, so in proportional each other related to the theoretical expectations that we had. Talking about the length of the molecular wires, we can say, as I told you, we have two different possibilities of current. Up to 2 to 3 nanometers, we have more tunneling current. If we have a longer length, we pass to have hopping current. And in this case, we have these two opposite phenomena, that a longer path, it is strictly related to the increase decrease in conductance, but from the other side, a longer length means a decrease in Ohm-Lummo gap. Here, again, I show you some results doing some simulation that we did, in which, depending on the thiophene number of rings of the thiophene, so to 1 to 8, you see that the Ohm-Lummo gap, as we have seen before, is decreasing. And in this case, we can see here the plot of the voltage, of the current on the voltage, so the IV characteristics of the different molecule. Here we have the blue one, as the highest current is with only one molecule. This one is the two molecule, and when we start to pass to 3, 4, 6, rings of thiophene, here the situation changes. And zooming it, you see that you have an exchange in the current conduction between the longer that, in this case, conducts better than the shorter. This is an interesting result that gives us the confirmation that what we told before is true of these two phenomena together. I can tell you that these simulations are interested and can be a good point to study for understanding if this behavior is also strictly related to what you can obtain in a real structure. Another interesting study that we can do, and we did, is to analyze, for example, taking two rings of thiophene, so a molecular wire of two thiophene, and to check if they are in this position or with a rotation of 90 degrees or with a rotation of 180 degrees. And you see that in the interesting conclusion is that the current from the green, where you have a 180 degree rotation, 19.0, changes. And I want to show you that the interesting thing is that the position, these are this 0 and 8, one, pi, let's say, rotation, they are in the same plane, the molecules, but the position of the sulfur is different. And so it changes the behavior of the molecule. In real life, let's say, the rotations are not of pi, as I show you. So we did also some study introducing rotation of less, we can say, from the theory and from some other studies, is proving that rotations can be about 20 degrees. And again, changing the rotation from 0, the blue one, to 20 degrees, we see that the current inside the structure changes. Another interesting point to study is the number of bonds, because you have your sulfur that will bond to the gold atoms. But depending on the position of the sulfur on the top of the grains, of top of the structure of the gold, of the atom golds that you have on the surface, you can have three different possibilities. If the sulfur is exactly in the center of three atoms of gold, this sulfur can create three bonds with the different atoms. If you have it in a sort of bridge between two atoms, you will have two bonds. If it finishes this preposition exactly on the top of a gold atom, in this case you can only have one bond. So the number of bonds changes the quality, how you create the contact. So we know now very well that this is one of the important things to analyze. And here you see we simulated the possibility, the different possibilities. So to have no bonding, to have two bonds, so one on the left and one on the right, 4 and 6. And here again we see an interesting simulation in which we have this one, the pink one, is related to the two bonds. This one is with one bond, this one with 4, and this one with 6 bonds. The interesting point is that with two bondings you start having a better conductance. This is a simulation. But it can happen because, again, we are not in a situation where the classical theories, the classical explanation can help us, but we are in we are talking about quantum physics, and so in this case the explanation is that this passing from two to other type of bondings change the structure, the energy levels of your molecules, and so in this case this can be a very interesting point to study. And what is shown in the previous plot, it did not become simply from maybe a strange behavior of a simulator, but I can say that now I cannot show you the real proof that this is the good result, because we did not do yet the experiments. It is not easy, you can imagine, to do these experiments. So we are in a field in which you must be careful to take conclusions, but I want to tell you that I do not consider these results a wrong result. I consider a result that has to be studied and analyzed, because the corresponding spectrum, a transmission spectrum of the 4 different situation is again gives us the fact that the results we obtained are correct. In fact, you see that the geometry, the shape of the transmission spectrum with the two bonds is very different from 4 and 6 bonds, and around the Fermi level you see that the situation is very different, and this can give you the difference in current inside your structure. So let's pass and finish our lecture in having a look of some experiments that we did here in Politecnico. First of all, we can analyze this paper in which they studied the processes that that happen in a structure like this, where you have your electron that, in this case, with the process A, through a tunnel current, so to a tunneling, can pass inside the barrier, and so give you, in this first part of your EV characteristic, this A line where you have the proportion between I and V. And this increase is linear. But inside this structure, it's also possible that in the structure you develop, you have a vibrational mode with a frequency of nu, we can call it nu now, and you apply a voltage, so for having an energy of EV more higher than H nu, the electron can lose this quantum of energy and to excite this vibrational mode nu at a frequency nu, and so to create a sort of parallel tunnel, process B here, this is an elastic and this is inelastic behavior, and so in this case you have sort of two parallel channels in which the electrons can pass, and so you increase your conductance, and so here you have these two lines, the B ones, that show you that the conductance here is higher. Okay? So, in fact, we expect is a behavior like this, but if you remember in the previous slide, it was a similar shape of IV characteristic of a molecule inside the electrodes. Taking again an example, here they did some experiment in this case an electrochemical cell. The molecule was an oligothiophene showed here down, where we have this oligothiophene long 10 nanometers, and in this case this was the characteristic that they obtained. The A is a situation where you do not have the presence of the molecule, and B, you see here, you have the difference in conduction, and the current is about from 10 to 20, 30 picoamperes. This is the shape and the behavior of the current in comparison with related to the applied voltage. What we did here, we use this octamer, so a molecule of thiophene with a length of 8 rings based on this basic structure that is a quarter thiophene, where two of these basic structures are linked together. We put them in our nanogap. And we did this thanks to the help also of the chemistry department of University of Modena in Italy, where the group there prepared for us these molecules. Here, the first study we did is just to check using an AFM microscope where the molecules were positioned. And here you see a situation where you have a lot of molecules. Here you can see that what I told you, the molecules find in the gap a sort of good energy stabilizing place where so they tend to stay and to go in the center, so this helps us a lot in our experiment, and we did these experiments applying a concentration of 2 micromolars. What I want to point you out here is that you see we do not have only a single molecule, but we have a lot of molecules. So we will see that the current is quite high because we do not have a single molecule conducting, but a lot of them in parallel. In fact, you see, I show you 2 examples of 2 different gaps in which we had this, the shape of the current is the one that we are expecting, and here we are talking of microamps, so quite high current, and this is the shape of the conductance plotted on the voltage applied. This is for one gap, and this is for another gap, the gap number 38, where you see here again a current of about tens of microamperes, and this is the behavior of the conductance. Now, I can say that we finish our short. I cannot say that I went too much in details, but I hope that I gave you an overlook of which are the useful molecules, which are the necessary parameters and studies we must do to understand the behavior of our molecules, and so to exploit this behavior for producing new nano devices. In the next lectures, we will continue in showing you the other type of molecules that are the non-conductive molecules useful for other type of application, and you will take the concepts that I explained today for applying directly in a laboratory using Virtual Nanolab for doing these different steps I just showed you, and also we will do together a complete experiment for producing our contacts, our nanogaps. Thank you for your attention.